Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see the new Microsoft Access 2016 quickly and easily. Leave us comments to improve our language in the future. Microsoft Access is a database management system software, a software used to collect, save and show data, very useful in a business environment. When you open Access, the startup window opens. Here, you can open any existing Access file or database on the left, or start from ready-made templates available from the net. To better understand how Access works, let's simply open a new blank desktop database. Before going on, it is important to know the fundamental elements that compose an Access database. A database is composed by different parts that are listed on the left: tables, forms, reports, queries, macros, and modules. Each of these behave differently and are used for different purposes. Let's start with the tables. These are indeed the most important elements inside your database, since they collect and save any kind of data. A table is composed by rows and columns. Columns, also called fields, are used to save a kind of data to import, for example a name, a comment, a date, a status, or a numeric value. Rows, or records, are used to list each set of data collected. For example, there will be as many rows as the colleagues you took data from. By default, you just have one field, called ID, that counts the number of rows field. This is also the primary key of the table interested. The click to add field is empty, through which you can add another field. You can add different kinds of data, long or short text, used to type inside, number to insert numbers, date and time to import by using a calendar, attachment to browse and import a file, and hyperlink to add a web address. Add as many fields as you need. Each single row will specify all data requested by those fields. You can adjust these fields as you need. If you right-click on the field name, you can rename or delete it if you need. Drag its contours to enlarge the space available. More complex are the calculated fields. These fields get filled auto, starting from the content of other fields. In this case, insert the expression through the expression builder that follows. If you need more help, just click on Help on the right. You can edit the expression later if you need, right-clicking on the field and going to Modify Expression. To adjust the text style inside a whole table, just change the settings under Text Formatting. Access gives you different views available in order to manage each element the best way. All views are listed in the bottom right corner. For tables, Datasheet View is used to collect data, while Design View is used to adjust each field settings. For each field on the left, you can set the data type on the right and all detailed settings at the bottom. For example, setting if data is required, the maximum text characters in field sides, and so on. If you need to build a table with another collection of data, just go to Create on top, and then on Table. The new table will appear in the list on the left. You can double-click on a table to open it, or right-click to rename and delete. Let's see how to import and export data with Access. Open the External Data tab. Use Import and Link section to import data from Excel, from another Access database, or any text file. Browse for the file that contains your data and decide how to import it by creating a new Access table, updating an existing table, or creating a table linked with your database The procedure is fully guided. To export data, select the table from the left and use the options under Export. When you finish working with a table, make sure to save and close it. Just right-click on its tab on the workspace to do so. If you start having lots of tables and data, you may need to use queries. A query is a single table that collects and summarizes data from more existing tables in one shot. To create a query, just click on Query Design inside Create tab. Then, select the tables you want to include inside the query table. Hold Ctrl down and click to select more tables. Then, click to add. All tables included in the query are shown on top, with all their fields and primary keys. At the bottom, you can build each query column. On field, select the data that each query column must have. You can select a whole table content indicated by the table name followed by an asterisk, or just a single table field indicated by the table name and the respective field name. Through the other rows below, you can set important settings. Switch to the datasheet view to check how your query table looks like. Very important is the filter. A filter is used to show data that meets your criteria and discards all data that is out. For example, if any data has the age field filled by a negative value, you can discard it by adding a measure 0 under the field age added inside the query in criteria. In this way, just all data that meets such criteria will show up in the query. You can directly type inside criteria or insert it with the expression builder by right-clicking and going to build. Mind that your query is strongly linked to your tables. If any cell is edited, the query will be automatically refreshed. To show off or print your data, use the reports. Select any table or query interested and click on Report under Create tab. Inside a report, you can't change any data, but just all that concerns how it must be shown, text style, basic structure and layout. Access has different views for reports. Report view shows a preview of the report. Print view shows a printed preview on a page. Layout view is used to set the basic structure and layout of the report. And design view is more concentrated on colors and shapes. By default, the report is built following the simple structure you see in the design view. A report header with a default picture and a title, a page header with labels that describe the report content, or report data under detail, and the footers that terminate your report with page numbers and any calculated cell. For example, the default one is added to a currency field in order to sum its total. You can add and edit any function going to Control Search under Property Sheet. You can open this dialog box, right-clicking on a cell and going to Properties. If you want to know all the functions you can use inside Access, check out the link in video description. Through this view, you have full control on the report, composed by different elements you can check through the property sheet. Images contain simple pictures, labels contain descriptions you can edit and type anytime, text boxes any field data that you can't change directly without the original table, or any calculated data. Through design on top, you can create and add other elements in your report. You may need more practice to use all of them in the best way. Through this view, you can size each element, dragging their contours. or move them by simply using the Move icon in the top left corner. The report always follows the original table layout. If you go to Arrange on top, you can adjust the basic layout and add rows and columns if you need. Format is used to adjust the font settings or introduce any filling and outline to each element. This will affect all the selected cells you have at the moment. Hold Ctrl down to select more cells. Forms are objects similar to reports, but used to collect more data inside your tables through a simple interface. To create a form, select a table and click on Form under Create tab. The form is composed by different records that correspond to each field row of your main table. The last record is blank, ready to be filled to import new data. The form can be edited as seen for reports through the layout and the design view. The form view is used to preview the form. In Access, you also have macros and modules elements used to automate actions and commands. We won't see these in this beginner tutorial. Let's see how to save and publish your Access database. To save your database, in order to store your data, go to File and then to Save As. If you choose any option inside Save Database As, you will save your whole database, including all its objects inside. If you want to save the Access object selected, choose Save Object As. If you need to collect and gather data, you need to publish your database and forms on the net. There are lots of different ways to publish on the net. Just go to the External Data tab and click on More. You can use SharePoint, an HTML document, or any online database. Check out the video description if you want to know more about how to publish your Access objects on the net. Thanks for watching. Check out our Office 2016 guide to discover more.